Hey, Michael, my name is Chris Taylor. I'm the social media manager over at Marcus Theaters. How are you?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Oh, man, I'm just living my best life over here, you know, just doing my best. How about you, man?
I can't complain. Doing the best we can. We're pushing through, and thank you for having me.
Oh, hey, man, thanks for sitting down with me. I appreciate it. I know your time is busy, and you're doing tons of interviews, and, you know, you're promoting Fatale, and so I appreciate the few minutes you have to sit down with me today. It means a lot.
Absolutely.
Well, hey, man, you know, congratulations. Fatale looks awesome. I mean, we haven't had a thriller like this in a while, you know, in theaters. And I'm really excited to see how the Marcus Theaters fans, you know, how they receive it, how they respond to it, both, you know, during the film and after. I'd love to get your thoughts. I mean, Derek plays, like, your character, Derek, he's a do the right thing kind of guy. You know, I mean, I think early on we see he's a hard worker, he's a family man, he wants to do the right thing, you know, and then there are moments where sometimes his darker side comes out and we see it kind of chronologically through the film. You know, how did you make sure to balance that, you know, with the way he works hard and we see him at the agency, right, with Rafe, and then, you know, on his personal turmoil, both, you know, with his wife and you know, with Hilary Swank's character. I mean, how did you balance that?
You know, I think that's a good question. I think trying to balance all of the different inner workings of Derek started with prep. You know, you prepare yourself for this kind of tightly wound performance, right? You know, under the circumstances, he's being manipulated by this kind of menacing character. And there's only so much you can do in prep, and a lot of it comes on set when you're actually in the moment and you're actually playing with this person or sparring with this person, literally and figuratively. And so you find yourself, you know, in prep trying to make sure, and you work with your director. I work very closely with Dion to make sure that I know exactly where I am in this moment, because you shoot out a sequence and stuff like that, and that can
be. Yeah.
But ultimately, you have to kind of just make sure you know exactly where you are so that it breathes well throughout and it feels consistent and it feels like an experience that's organic, to be honest with you.
Absolutely. You know, it's there are moments in the film where, and I think more specifically, when you're first brought in for questioning, right? And then you're kind of looking through the mirror and there's so much symbolism there, and you see Detective Quinlan kind of given that crazy look on the backside, right? You're like, man, and I said this to Mike Coulter yesterday, like, there are so many moments in the film where it's like, are your eyes deceiving you? Did I just see that weird look? Like, is he doing something? Is she doing something? You know, and you almost feel bad for Derek because, you know, he's just trying to do him, you know, and then something happens and it's like the whole world just falls apart, you know, like your heart goes out to him, you know?
You know, it's interesting to the goal, you know, I remember feeling like talking to Dion and Roxanne about this early on, like, if I can do what I do at the beginning of this movie and still have people root for me, then I will feel like I did my job. And so Absolutely. Thank you for saying that, one. And two, that scene that you spoke of in the interrogation room.
Yeah.
There's something kind of cool about that scene. We didn't know we had that until we rehearsed that scene. So that was a location and we were in there and it wasn't supposed to be shot that way. But Dante and Dion started, when they saw it in rehearsal, they started saying, hey man, what about, look at this reflection. And next thing you know, man, Dante just took a minute and just framed everything in that scene so beautifully.
Yeah, of all your scenes, that's the one that stood out to me the most. Like, I actually paused the film. I was like, wow, like, yeah. You really couldn't have set that up better. I mean, like, you know, just setting your scene, that was powerful.
I say work with good people, man, because that was just organic and creative and using what you got.
I love that.
So it
I love
was
that
incredible scene. Thank you.
Hey, my pleasure. Well, I'm getting the old hook here. Hey, just wanted to say, you know, thank you once again, and nothing but blessings and good fortune to you, my friend, as always. Michael, thank you so much, my friend. Hopefully we get to see more movies with you on our big screen sooner rather than later.
I agree with that.
Happy holidays, brother.
All right.
Thanks.
Thank you.